Oh,
Hi,
Kyle.
boys. Recording has started. Gentlemen. It's been a weird week. Crashed on Hoth, fighting these scavengers. We finally pushed them back, but this whole base was absolutely annihilated when we got here. Consular was dead on arrival. Impaled on a spike. Whew, Christ. Well, we've set up Point Bravo. You just held a short homage to those who have died before us, getting us this far. I was able to send out a small signal out into the depths of space in the general direction of Coruscant earlier today. Unfortunately, the electronics needed to do so was a lot of our weapon supplies. What we have is what we got. Nothing more. Everything else is good as shot. Though, we've been able to rally a lot of the troops. We believe this is all we have. Some of you 420th back there from the consular ship, some 15th that were rambling around from an escape pod they hopped into, and a bunch of 87th. We don't got much else left. Look, we're low on options here. We can wait for that signal and s hope a random signal floating through space gets us out of here. But something deep in my gut, in my soul, tells me that our answers, what we seek, is at that energy signal. From what I've been able to discern about its architecture from here, it predates a lot, especially this iteration of the Republic. I believe it is old Republic era, the same stuff the scavengers were using. We haven't detected any scavenger activity after we found most of them dead, with advanced blaster marks through them at this base. So here's the play. We move in, we deal with any defenses it may have, and we blow that place to hell after we find what we want there. If we don't find what we want, we grab what supplies we can from there and try to hold out. Any questions?
No,
Have you been able to sense anything from the temple?
sir. It puts me off. It's almost as if it's clouding my vision. Like my very sight is diminished just by being within its presence. I don't want to alarm anyone, but it definitely stinks of the rot that is the Sith. I don't know what that is. I think it might be a temple of some sorts. I've heard stories in the Jedi archives. Temples with wells of energy scattered across the galaxy. I've heard tales of a robotic intelligence utilizing Old Republic tech that seems to concentrate around these areas. And judging by the fact that we're finding droids of technology we haven't found before, I guess it's best to say those rumors aren't just rumors anymore. It is our best shot to move into that temple and find out what is going on. And we're gonna see this through. One way or another. You will utilize anything at base, and individually, you will have command of all of the forces we have. Lieutenant, you can take the left
Yes, sir.
side.
Left side.
And, Sergeant, stand still for me, will ya? Congrats. You're a Sergeant Major now. You get the right side. We move out.
Yes, sir.
Immediately. May the Force be with you. Always.
Thank you, General.
Force be with you.
Channel switched.
Always.
Channel
Even if it's
switched.
Just us two, that's fine.
No, Alright, well, I guess we'll go hop the fence.
Make sure you have long ranges!
Yep, I do.
Good, good. Sergeant Major now. Yes. Sergeant Major now. Congrats. Sergeant Major now. Whew. And so So it begins.
You know, looking back at this, this isn't a bad little, photo.
Oh, frick. One, two, three, four. I have 19 people in my group, which means they're all going to be trying to get to me. Right now. Up top, back over the wall.
Got it.
We'll plan once we're both back outside.
Yep.
This is Sergeant Major Garmar sending on to long range 6-0.
Good to hear it, Sergeant Major. This is Lomas. What we've detected before, some things you'll need to know. The structure appears to be within three zones. One is an outer zone around the actual compound. One is an inner area that is set into multiple sections with towers for defending, and the other seems to be around a single structure, one of which we have not been able to ascertain the nature of. It seems to bend visible light around it, and only seems to form when we get close, but when we do with any electronics, just before it seems to form, it, well, cuts to black. It hasn't exactly been the nicest of ordeals. There also appears to be a figure that seems to stand by the gate inside the secondary wall. Around it, we've detected several life signs that have both entered and diminished over the past 48 hours. We've also detected several, well, I don't know what to call them. They seem to be constructs? They look like droids, definitely Old Republic tech, but they're modified in an odd way. They seem to patrol around. A scavenger patrol went in around us, and they were slaughtered within minutes by these things. If even they are wiped out that easily, I'm lucky we have this many men. We're gonna need every last one. We're not detecting many other anomalies in the area. Though the amount of energy within that construct, within that compound, it's immeasurable. I don't know what you'll find in there, but I will have your back.
Garmer copy, super.
Understood. Out. The assault commence. Be advised, we were able to scrounge up two slightly damaged and slightly unfueled transports on the south side of the of our base. Well, the base that we stole, technically, but we do have those. They're a little low on fuel and ammunition, but they might be useful. Otherwise, if you want to go on foot, up to you. All those soldiers are at your command. And good luck. Lomas out. Whew! Oh, yes. This is the final countdown. This is it, gamers. This is the final bit. This is the final bit. Only enter on. Okay, got open voice mod for the, what is essentially the master from Fallout. But, this is Kronos, the creator of these droids. He has an expansive network throughout many Old Republic Sith temples, and he is here to, essentially exterminate any and all things that get in his way. Crawl with you, Garmor. We go, boys. I can show them we're not fucking around. Be advised, a massive abject just... Oh my crap. Wait one. What in the hell is that? First order music time, boys.
Hey, Loomis, we see it, over. We're betting it's a capital ship of some sort, over.
Be advised, I'm going to consult my records. Continue moving in if, shit.
Lomas, I think you cut off there. Say again, over.
Nothing, I just... That is... That's not... Be advised, according to my records, that's a... A Sith Star Destroyer? But... What the sh...
General, are we still cleared with our mission, over?
Yes. Continue with the mission. I'll be joining you shortly.
1-2 copy is out.
Holy shit, dude. I love how that looks. That is indeed what appears to be a obviously modified, but that's a Star Destroyer from the Sith Empire. It's Old Republic era, but I don't know what the hell that thing has on it. Looks like it's been outfitted with some turbo laser batteries. Continue moving in. I'll see what I can do. This doesn't look good.
This 1-2 copies, we figured as much about turbo lasers.
This doesn't look good. I also do not know what those cannons are on the bottom. Those don't look too nice. Oh shit, dude! With the black smog, it's glorious. Holy, I might have brought it in a little prematurely.
Advisor, this is 1-2, over.
I copy. What is it?
It appears my men have forgotten how to go into a witch formation, over.
Understood. Pay it no mind. It's probably just the. It's probably just the weather. Gets to your head. Sad Garmor noises. Lats.
Awaiting orders. Ready. Ready.
switch. Channel switch.
Advisor, this is 1-2. Looks like something's noticed us and has opened up with purple tracers. Over.
Understood. Continue moving in. Ah, shit. Shit. This is how we'll stand a chance. Be advised, what do you see down there, the structure?
Those two rings of walls like, you said earlier, otherwise it looks empty. I mean, there's maybe a container down there that I can't see clearly, but otherwise it's empty besides the ship.
Understood, I'll take that as a good sign.
Advisor, this is 1-2, starting to take heavy fire. Both squads, over.
Understood. Continue pushing. I'll see what I can do. Please tell me you're working, please. Please, it's main op time, please!
Rag, I'm gonna try to split my squad up into teams, make them smaller targets.
Whew, he's digging a trench, good for him. Boys! Take a look!
One tube copies, acclimator scene.
Hell yeah!
Be advised, starting to take aerial contact with those scout ship fighters that we've encountered before. Advisor, I've lost all contact with 1-1. Moving to check on their last known position, over.
Understood. Please work. Please, just move. Why is this so difficult?
Advisor, this is 1-2. We've taken ground force contact from east side of compound over on the outside.
Understood. Can you identify? I've got some good things on comms over here.
Scavengers, but unable to clearly identify at this time, over.
Understood. Please tell me when you can.
Channel switched.
All right,
Advisor, this is 1-2, over.
I know that.
So don't say I did.
You just told me.
No, that isn't what I just told you.
You told me that you had homework.
Yes, I did, but I didn't say I did.
User joined your channel.
Advisor, this is 1-2, over.
Advisor copies. What you need?
Be able to relay to the lot currently stationary over the compound that we need gun runs on horses just outside of the compound on the eastern wall, over.
Understood. We'll relay immediately. We apparently got friend lots pair dropping in from above.
Copy. Over.
Got it.
Yeah, I'm trying to work on him right now.
Perfect.
Channel
Beautiful.
Switched.
Channel
These
switched.
Are droids of some sort. Advisor, this is 1-2, over.
1-2 copies, what is it, 1-1?
We've identified enemy combatants or droids of some sort.
Understood. You able to handle them?
Say again, over.
Are Are you able to handle them?
A-firm, over. 1-2 out.
User left your channel.
See up there, I swear to fucking god.
User joined your channel.
Hey,
advise, make sure you enter through the entrances. Don't go over the walls or anything.
User left your channel.
Arma incidents.
User joined your channel.
1-2 copies. Be advised, I have a one-time squad leader waiting for a reinsert. Over.
Understood. We'll insert now.
Advise, it seems the ship doesn't want to fire on this compound. Over.
Understood, that's a good thing. I'll make sure we tell the troops to get the hell in there then. Unfortunately, it's like total kill count. Losses on our end. About 50 soldiers so far. Let's try to keep it that low. Be advised, when you do enter, there should be an entrance on the western side of the compound, and in the secondary well, there should be an entrance on the eastern side. They definitely didn't want anyone getting in.
1-2 copies, was just trying to see if I could get up in the tower. Over.
Understood. Good luck. Out.
Advisor, this is 1-2. They've got some sort of energy-based weapon that's able to selectively strike down units. Over.
That is not good. Make sure you get in there as quick as you can. I'm talking with the captain of the acclimator. Hopefully you got our signal.
1-2 copies, in all honesty, the lightning kind of resembles close to what you Jedi have described Sith lightning like. Over.
Mildly unsettling, but continue moving in. Should be able to find.
depth here, is it possible they're using whatever that thing is in the center to enhance whatever they're trying to do? Over.
It is possible. However, unlikely. Definitely possible.
User in your channel timed out.
No! No, not doing a main op! No! Fuck! Who the fuck is taking up the internet? Stop! No! Fuck.
Connected.
Pause, Sim.
Channel
switch. Pause, Sim. Oh.
Channel switched.
Whew.
Channel switched.
Christ, Rag's description is emotionally scarred. You better not be in the fucking compound already. Okay, he paused Sim. Thank you.
User disconnected from your channel.
Who the Timmy did. F. Resume Sim. Apologies, my Arma DC'd there for a minute. Ground team, what's the current status?
Same, except I just lost one. Hey, you wanna put that respawn tent outside the entrance?
Oh shit, the spikes.
Guys, move. Damn it. Now, no. Hey, I guess it's going out there. Oh my god.
Oh, okay, so I can sound like this. Kronos himself. It's perfect. I believe.
Looks like a lot of your troops are out of ammo. Troopers are out of ammo.
That guy started his crystal, so I don't know.
Oh.
Hang on. What's that thing? Oh, that's the container I was able to see.
Don't mind that breaking.
See anything?
Yeah, don't come close.
What's up, 1-1? Rag, what's up? Oh, better you than me.
Yeah.
Was on the eastern side.
Silence.
Channel switched. Channel switched.
That ship.
In a chatty mood? Rag, are you feeling in a chatty mood?
If you fight me, you will turn out like Loris.
Covering.
Tonight, I want to talk. we... I am sure we can come to an agreement.
It's a lot of dead Jedi.
Yeah, I know.
User left your joined your channel.
That is a lot. Kronos? I am merely an avatar. Kronos lies within the temple itself. He finds you most curious. Those are ones. Then. Those are both Jedi and Sith. Who wished to use the temple for their own gain. They met a cruel fate. Kronos believes you may be reasoned with. Only one may enter. Wait.
What temple is this?
This is a Sith. That has stood for many a year. He has repurposed many old Empire technology for his own goals. He is an avatar mind created to serve the galaxy. And now he seeks to reason with it. With you.
Okay, then.
You will find what you seek within the light of the temple. Only two may enter. No more, no less.
Oh, wait. Okay, then.
You will be teleported and transported by the temple to Kronos. There he shall explain.
Okay, so...
If you leave...
...to give us an explanation?
But only if, out of respect. I must ask that you leave all weapons here. He guarantees that no harm will befall you within his care. And so defeat the purpose of wanting to meet you. You have piqued his interest. What do you say?
Lieutenant, you're not even questioning this a little bit?
Yeah, I'll go.
You are... but... Oh, they're probably saying what's on the screen!
Channel switched. Channel switched. Channel switched. Channel switched.
Is he just fucking channel out of switched. There saying bomb the temple? Or what? They've come.
What do we have to discuss?
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Kronos, a long-forgotten acronym. I have been trapped in this godforsaken temple for too long. I see a way out. A way to save the galaxy from itself. No matter what. Back in the days. Allow me to elaborate. Back in the days of the Old Republic and the Sith Empire, I was constructed to oversee both. No matter what has changed. Despite the fact that millennia have passed, I have overseen the galaxy from hundreds of worlds and hundreds of temples. Nothing has changed. Suffice to say, this is not the optimal outcome. I simply wish for life to have the greatest chance to flourish. That cannot happen while life is allowed to flourish this much. I will utilize my modified technology, backed by the ancient power of the Sith artifacts located across the galaxy. And I will bring a new era of peace and stability to the galaxy. I see the Republic. Easy. The reason we are constantly at war, current war being the Clone War, is because of very, very simple feud that has spanned the ages. The Jedi and the Sith. My readings and calculations indicate that if they are eliminated, both sides, fairly and equally, indiscriminately massacred, we will have peace, and the galaxy can decide for itself its own fate, free from the grasps of good and evil. I was hoping we may be able to come to a peaceful resolution. Unfortunately, many lives will be lost in my long conquest, and I am almost prepared to ship off across the galaxy. Many civilians and many peoples unaffiliated will die in the initial onslaught. This is unfortunately the best outcome. I was hoping that you may be able to see things my way. And that, at least with you, who were sufficient enough to get past the ruse of the scavengers I was using to cover my tracks here on the Hoth system, I may be able to have some use for you. Please, enough about me. What are your thoughts?
Aren't you technically a Sith, though? Or...
I am powered by ancient Sith artifacts known as holocrons. I am also made out of a mortal construct, an ancient worm, a dark god, if you will. I provided force power for the Sith here on Hoth. It was the alternative, their form of the Ilum system. It is where they went to gather Kyber crystals and learn and hone their power. Of course, I saw that they were ruled by their emotions. I betrayed them despite the augmentations they made, and I have become a living god in the process. As you can see, the HK-51 modified are very, very robust machines. I have them in upwards of the 10,000s. Not even the Separatist army parallels in comparison. Unfortunately, the death that will come from my initial onslaught will be a necessary evil to end the Clone War and usher peace into the galaxy. This is the only outcome.
So, are you saying that you would bring peace to the galaxy?
I am saying I would, by annihilating the Jedi Order and the Sith entirely. Of course, anyone affiliated with them has also got to go. Though I am willing to make an exception for you too. What are your thoughts?
Why am only an exception for us two?
You seem to possess... Well, you on the left to my view have a keen sense of leadership and a keen sense of responsibility. This is invaluable for a general. And you on the right, you have an invaluable sense of duty. And I have grown to respect your combat prowess. The only thing I must say is that any other Republic forces on Hoth will be killed in this outcome. If you are with me, they must die. For they cannot all have the pleasure, nigh the nobility, nigh of conquesting the galaxy alongside me. I am giving you this. Believe me when I say I have been calculating this plan for millennia. No matter what, I cannot be wrong. This is the only path to peace.
Where exactly did that beam take us?
You see, you are deep within the planet, underneath the temple on Hoth. That is why I have the scavenger ruse there, to throw off any forces that may discover the temple. They would merely think it has already been picked and forgotten. I have had to load up and recharge its dark reactor core, however, in order to power the weapons I have been manufacturing. Trust me when I say, you will join me, or you will die. There is one other directive that I must stand by. My creator had hard programmed into my coding. If a mortal being is able to find a flaw within any of my plans, I would rig my systems to self-destruct. I do not know why he made this. It seems almost futile. However, I am hard programmed to adhere to it. Hence, you are here.
Wait, so if you're powered by Sith holocrons, how many do you have? Just this one in front of us, or do you have multiple?
I have hundreds across the galaxy. My main facility is here.
By this one?
No. I myself am powered by many remotely. And the influx of force energy I harvested from those that have died today has given me enough to run for years without them.
If you're powered by the Sith holocrons, won't you be corrupted by that?
That was not my concern, and is none of mine. My creator built me.
But
I do not know why he did it, why it is.
If that's not your concern, but wouldn't you become evil and corrupted and become a Sith?
I highly doubt that outcome. I merely draw energological data from the holocrons. I do not give in to any of the Sith teachings. None are adhered to in any of my policy.
How do you know that a future without either Jedi or Sith is better than a future that has them, with potentially the Jedi winning?
When the Sith stood in power, their emotions ruled them, and they tore each other apart at their throats, ripping down their own thrones with their bare hands. And then they were wiped out by the Jedi. But with the Jedi in power, they allowed the current Sith to grow in power and muster their strength, causing the Clone War to begin. I am positive the Sith and the Jedi are just as responsible for the Clone War. I do not believe any is any less responsible by my estimates. Accuracy coefficient 99%.
Okay, so if you were to become, let's just say, a quote-unquote god after you killed the Jedi and Sith, wouldn't the people want to rebel?
What
and
would they rebel
that would create
against?
A war against
I,
you.
But the Jedi,
you're calling yourself a god. The Jedi aren't calling themselves god.
No one person can truly rule correctly by themselves.
Running the diagnostics. I
reason why the Senate exists is to stop against corruption of any individual being able to affect the entire galaxy. You'd have no safeguard against that.
Attention! Facility detonation and all equipped in T-minus 1 minute.
Okay, then.
No. What have you done?
Let's run.
Oh, I'm stuck. That's not good.
Okay, you're not stuck.
Alright, I grabbed the Sith holocron. I grabbed the holocron and book it.
No! No! Impossible!
Repeat, do any units copy in the area? What the bloody hell is going on out there? Do any units copy?
We copy,
What in the hell's been going on? I've lost you for a fucking... You've been gone for 6 fucking hours. What's going on?
We'll tell you when we get back to base. We need to talk to Lomas.
Understood. Sending in a lat to pick you up. We're detecting a massive energy spike from that place. I'd get the bloody hell away from there.
Yes.
Be advised, we're in the LZ marked by blue smoke. Over.
Waiting orders.
Did all that just crash?
Negatory, lat is still inbound.
Oh, we just saw a lat crash down.
We're still getting readings.
Be advised, remarkable smoke.
right below you.
Understood. Looks like that energy reading is gone. This is Lomas calling to you guys. I'm currently on board the Onslaught. We're getting ready to get out of here.
1-2 copies over. We're awaiting pickup and then we should be on board in shortly over.
Understood. What did you guys find in there? I repeat, what exactly did you find in there?
We met a person named, or not a person, a program or robot or something. Named Cronus. Cronus, something like that.
It was a weird sentient program or something like that. We're not sure.
Channel
switched. Channel switched.
I see. Well, come here and I'll answer what I can. Come on down. We'll discuss things on ground before we board up and get out of here. Be advised where you guys headed.
Be advised what?
Where exactly are you guys going?
East of the base.
Understood.
Not the ship. Wait, are we going in the ship, or...
No, please come down and talk to me. I have a few things to talk about.
Please. Go down.
Hello.
Hey, Lomas.
Hello. Lieutenant? Sergeant Major?
Yes. You want to debrief on everything that went down in there?
I want to know what happened from your perspective. You guys entered that temple and you've been gone for about 6 hours.
6 hours? It did not feel like 6 hours. I've had.
We were only in there for maybe 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Well, what exactly did you guys experience?
Well,
because we lost contact when you went inside the temple.
Yeah.
What happened?
We went in. We were contacted by he called himself like an avatar of this being called Cronus. At the time, we thought it was a being anyway. Well,
yeah, there's an entity of some sort.
Yeah. And he said that we looked promising for him. So we went inside the temple, and I guess somewhere in that we lost our time, I guess. Then we got sent into this room with this being multiple turrets, and in the middle, and with a control panel or something like that in the middle of it. He basically said that his goal was to kill the Sith and kill the Jedi's and let there be no war.
I thought that removing both the Jedi and the Sith would bring ultimate peace to the galaxy.
That's ludicrous.
We know.
Yeah.
That's just insane.
Yeah,
what exactly?
He said he had multiple, like, hundreds of thousands of droids, HK-25s, 35s. He said they were modified.
I think whatever we were fighting to get in.
To get in.
Dear God.
Those.
By the living.
And he told us that there was one problem in a system which he shouldn't have. And that problem is with his plan, whether or not we should. Or with his plan, find a flaw in it, and he'll self-destruct, and we found a flaw in it.
What was that flaw? What was that flaw, Sergeant Major?
It was that if he became a god, which he believed he could by removing both Jedi and Sith, wouldn't be able to stop himself from being corrupted. Which is why we have the Senate to stop corruption in the galaxy from taking root.
Agreed. The Senate's about the most robust form of democracy ever. I can see no way why anything would be able to penetrate it. Good that you use that. Well, as far as things from up here, we've mainly cleaned up. There was a lot more of those droids that came in. A lot of those constructs, those flying ones, were defending the temple. We were able to fight them off. But the hyperdrive's moving up. We're going to head straight back to Coruscant and regroup. There's a few other squads, but not much. We're lucky the... Yes?
It was powered by something called a Sith Holocron. And he had almost a countless amount of them at his disposal.
Mm-hmm.
What? Do you have it with you?
The one that we saw was destroyed in the explosion.
Damn.
And also, Lomas, any chance on Coruscant, can we go talk to a Jedi Master or something of sorts?
We request that we're there with you when you make your report, since we were so directly involved in this.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be hard to get you in, but, this is a very serious matter. I'm going to speak with Master Windu about this on the Jedi Council. And we'll see how this goes. Otherwise, guess this is when we say goodbye to this godforsaken hellscape.
To next, sir.
Who knows?
For a number of dead Jedi outside the temple, I was able to recover a lightsaber from them. I don't know if you,
It's an older design, but...
Jedi or
no, that's
a lightsaber,
one.
But... Oh.
Yeah, that's the one we recovered.
It's definitely an older design, but... Thank you.
Further?
It's the one. All the other ones were... they looked destroyed. That was the only intact one that we could find.
Hmm.
Well, boys, let's get a move on. Let's get off this rock. Bring that with you, will ya? Thank you. One of you can drive if you'd wish.
I'll fly.
Thanks. I'm not one for flying. The droids are full.
Take us out. Channel switched.
Out of here.
Channel switched.
Take us away. perfect.
Channel switched. User joined your channel.
Absolutely perfect.
Yeah.
Is the right response indeed. All right. Out of game debrief. That was awesome. That was awesome to Zeus. Hell yeah.
Fun.
So apparently
hell yeah.
The acclimators actually are solid objects and Venators are not.
Yes, it is very strange.
No, I think the top of the acclimators aren't solid. You can get.
I know, and it's fucked up because I can't place turrets on them. All right, out of game debrief, real quick. You guys did that extremely well. You moved in on the temple. It was our last ditch effort. We were able to get out of Simnel at the expense of the rest of our electronics, and luckily, some Republic, the Devastator, you know, picked up that signal and went in to help us. But there was a. modified Ancient Sith Dreadnought over the fucking thing that came to defend it, along with all those HK-51s that were modified, and it basically slaughtered the rest of the troops other than you guys. Yeah, it was meant for a lot of other people, apologies for that. But, and then you went in and you realized the whole secret antagonist behind the whole thing, Kronos, which if you don't know, is a name I pulled from... Syndrome's plan in The Incredibles.
And here I thought you were talking about the Mad Titan Cronus.
No, also that, I guess. Could draw some inspiration. But his whole plan is... There is so many Sith and Jedi...
Yeah, that was
if we,
amazing, though.
If we wipe them all out... Basically, you know, if
anyway.
No one is like... If no one... If no one's special, or, you know, the whole thing from Incredibles, if everyone's super, or if no one's super, no one will ever be, and everyone can just be normal and have to deal with that. And basically, the Kronos AI had essentially over its millennia of existence, no one had ever come to challenge it. Most had just tried to destroy it and failed miserably. And those were both Jedi and Sith sitting outside there. Even the Sith didn't like that thing because it took over the temples. And
right.
You guys were able to wipe out its entire operation because did have a failsafe in place that if a mortal being, because it considered itself to be a machine, like a worm-ish god, and it was corrupted, and it couldn't tell, but it was corrupted by the dark side, hence how it was saying stuff like, even though, you know, there'll be many casualties at the beginning, this is just fine. And then I slipped in a few things here and there. That was all pre-written, by the way. I slipped in a few things in there where it was like, you know, he started throwing in stuff like malfeasant at one point. He started throwing in like comparing other people as puny worms. He was saying like, you know, he thought of himself as a higher being. And, you know, he knows what's best. And ultimately, that was really his flaw. And you guys did that expertly. I love the roleplay. Sorry if it dragged on a bit, but oh, that was awesome. And now we're off to regroup at Coruscant. That
was
awesome.
I was sitting there with the lightsaber. I'm like, all right, Rag, lightsaber's in your backpack. On three, let's whack this machine and run for it.
What did you think of the actual look of the machine?
Looked okay. I mean, it didn't look bad, so, eh.
Yeah, what did it... Yeah. It's a Sarlacc with a CIS command center shoved down its throat.
Oh, that thing, right. Okay, yeah. I thought you meant the tiny little console thing. Okay.
Yeah. No. I'm talking about Okay, if it was cool, that's good. Okay, so let's just go through the basic three questions, starting with Rag and then Garmor. How was it from a story perspective? Rag? Okay, Garmor, you go.
Story was good. Great finale. I presume this was the finale.
I mean, yeah. It was, like, if you guys had failed to push into that temple, I would have had two more ops. Where one of which we would have been running away from we would have been running away from the forces and learning even more to hype them up even more. And then the acclimator would have come in during the end of that op, and we would have had a huge assault on that temple. But again, the server might not have handled that. How were frames sitting, by the way?
Solid.
That's good. And that brings me to the next question. How was it from a visuals perspective? Like, how did... Because what that was a First Order dreadnought. How did that look? And the beam is a custom script. How did those look?
It looked good. I mean, again, I'm set to everything on low with 67% sampling, so it's going to look like trash for me, but...
Yeah.
I don't know.
And how was that from a gameplay perspective? I know that you died twice. Apologies for that. I was meant to micromanage those droids, but the first time you did...
Twice in the...
Yeah. Apologies for that. But, what did you think of it? Was it a good balance of running, fighting, and talking, or?
What did I miss?
I'm just running through the questions.
Skip your turn, and we'll come back to you.
Yeah.
Combat-wise, there were 7 units the entire mission. So, besides them engaging us for two clicks, not really anything until we got up where we could actually shoot them. At which point,
what did you think of What did you think of the cannons on the dreadnought?
It was good. I thought Rag murdered by them at one point because I lost visual and...
I know, I heard that. But no, he was just sitting there digging a trench.
Sorry about that.
All right.
A little bit of an emergency happened.
Right. It's fine. And Rag, I'll just go through you the three questions before we go to custom thoughts or, you know, personal things we'd like to add, PTSs essentially. Rag, how was that from a story standpoint? How was it from visuals, and how was it from gameplay? Lol. So, Rag, what do you think? And he's silent again. All right. that was about an hour and 30 minutes, though. I'm happy with that length. That was nice.
Yeah, I would say any longer, and it would have started to drag on.
Yeah. Do you think the ending was a little forced, maybe?
No, it was fine.
Like, were you thinking... I want to ask. Were you thinking in your head, what in the ever-loving hell are we supposed to do? There's a dreadnought above it. And then the acclimator jumps in behind. How was that?
As soon as the acclimator showed up, I'm like, okay, that'll deal with other stuff we deal with, the stuff we deal with.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, Rag, your questions, go.
Before you disappear.
Go. How was it from story? How was it from visual? How was it from gameplay? Rag, dang it! God almighty.
Alright, Rag?
I will... Yeah, okay, Rag, how was it from the standpoints?
I don't know
what the fuck? No! Tell him to relog.
Or is he even talking?
Tell him to relog!
Hey, Rag,
user
you can hear
disconnected
me.
From
oh,
your
okay.
channel.
Oh, he got it. Oh, Christ. Of course this happens. I mean, hey, for a main op with two people, did I make it seem like a big finale?
Yeah, it was good, considering the player count.
Yeah, I tried my best. I'm glad. Also,
wait,
congratulations.
Just been sitting there. Oh, sorry. Yeah, go ahead.
Congratulations on the promotion.
Okay. Wait,
thank
sorry.
You.
All right. Yep. Go ahead, Rag. What are your questions? The questions. What? How was it from story? How was it from visual? How was it from gameplay? In that order, please.
Oh, story and visual were amazing. Especially the story. I wasn't expecting to take out a robot by talking to it.
Good old Fallout. I kind of took inspiration yeah. on the Master from Fallout 1. Do you guys both know what that is?
Mm-hmm.
Vaguely, yeah.
Thinking of
yeah, it's a sen-
or,
yeah.
The Fallout 3.
Yes, okay, yeah. That was the that was one of the other inspirations behind this. I've been plotting this since day one of the Hoth campaign, by the way. Did you notice that the, underground place you were in is actually just the Hoth hangar?
I noticed it was
yeah.
up in the sky.
Yes. Alright. Rag, how was it from gameplay? What did you think?
You know, it was pretty fun. Kind of wish there were more people inside, but whatever. We kind of spent
yeah.
the entire time running around trying to
exactly. I took a while. So, I knew for a fact, because I ran this through like a bunch of times with AI, and I knew for a fact that those HK-51s were going to give you a hard-ass time. So I made sure to accommodate for that by making it, you know, you don't have to go through a bunch of other crap once you hit the temple. Okay. PTSs.
Yeah.
Garmor, go.
So I still have Holocron. And I still have a lightsaber that I did not give to Lomas.
You
which
didn't?
Which is why Rag's like, we recovered two and I kept one.
You actually kept it.
Yep,
I'm gonna
the Sith Holocron in my backpack and the lightsaber hidden somewhere.
I hope you know, I am going to put that into the story now of the next place we go. Or maybe the place after that. I'm gonna keep that in mind.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Okay. Anything else, Garmor?
It's a lightsaber. I'm not giving it up.
Okay,
no, that's it from me. I mean, I don't know what we're going to do with the Sith Holocron at this point. Our plan
was
to
give it to...
Yeah, our plan was to bypass Lomas and just hand it to the council directly. Since Lomas was so shaken up over the entire campaign.
I mean, yeah, like, out of character, Lomas isn't Force-sensitive, so this is pretty fucking shocking for him that he has to deal with all this shit. I mean, he's basically he's essentially a civilian with a lightsaber. And
yeah,
so he's just sitting there like, excuse me, what the fuck?
Yeah, I didn't want to risk him getting corrupted if he suddenly became Force-sensitive by being exposed to it.
Yeah.
Immediately being converted to the dark side.
Exactly, because he is species Sith, but of course he tries to hide that, but I'm pretty sure you guys could put that together. Like, he's the same species as that avatar was, a Sith.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he covers that up and everything, and his excuse for it is, well, it's not exactly like people who get rescued want to look and see a Sith rescuing them. That's never good. But,
yeah.
Yeah. Any other thoughts anyone would like to add? I'll take the silence as a profound no. All right, now here's what we're going to do. We are going to take a vote based on the people who have come to this final op. Where do you want to go next? Then. The two options are Natu, a water planet, which is known for heavy techno-union research facilities being there. Specifically, mechanical research, not bioweapons. Or, we could go to Dantooine. Dantooine is specifically... Got it.
Good training scuba, for actual combat skills.
Got it.
Also, scuba troopers not existent yet.
Yep, yeah, it's actually being built. Kind of It'll be ready, though. Alright. Dope, dudes. Alright, we're going to Dantooine next. Congratulations on your promotion, Garmor. Wear it with pride.
Will do.
And remember, Garmor, basically think of Sergeant Major as Sergeant, except you're the one... Think like just a Major Sergeant, yeah. So, like, you're... It's almost no different. You still run with Field Command. You're still running with the rest of the unit in battle.
Yeah.
You're just the one who, like, if Zeus is like, hey, please don't fucking go here. I'm building shit. Or if they're like, you're the one who, you know, normally you're the one who, you know, talks to, like, Rag and stuff once we get more people. You're that.
So
congratulations, Garmor.
Am I being promoted to Sergeant Major? Am I being moved into 2nd Platoon?
No, actually.
So...
I talked to Kana, and they are shifting down to Sergeant. And they said they were fine with it, and they understand that they've been inactive, so they say something like this is only fair. So, that is that. I already sorted it out, and congratulations. You are now... Sergeant Major of 1-1. Dragonfire 1, essentially. Congratulations.
Right. Thank you.
I tried to do it in, like, you know, Avengers style. Boop, boop, you're an Avenger now. Boop, boop, you're Sergeant Major now.
Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna go eat some tacos and watch some JoJo.